Hello friends, welcome to GT Science tutorial. In this video, I'm going to explain about selection rule for vibrational spectra. In my previous video, I have already explained about the selection rule for rotational spectra. So before watching this video, please go and watch that video. I'll put the link in the description. You can check from there. So in this video, we are going to see some rules that are needed to follow by the molecules in order to form the vibrational spectra. So let's start. Just like rotational spectra, there are two rules in vibrational spectra as well. First of all, let's discuss about the first rule. The first rule is the transition occurs between the adjacent vibrational energy levels. Between the vibrational energy levels, that means del V must be equal to plus minus 1. So plus 1 is for what? Absorption of energy, absorption, and minus 1 for emission of energy, right? So this is the first rule that are needed to be followed by the molecule in order to form the vibrational spectra. That means the transition will occur only between the adjacent vibrational energy levels. Let's understand this by diagram. Suppose these are vibrational energy levels. This is 0 point. This is plus 1, plus 2, plus 3, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. If the molecule is here, then if it gets energy to form vibrational spectra, it must be transit to only one energy level up. If it loses energy, then it must lose to get to one energy level down. If this happens, then only it can form vibrational spectra. So this is the first condition. That means the transition will occur only between the adjacent energy levels. Now let's see the second rule. The second rule says that the molecules must not have permanent dipole moment, but its dipole moment must change on vibration. Its dipole moment must change on vibration. As we are talking about vibrational energy, then obviously the molecule will vibrate. And if the molecule vibrates, then the permanent dipole moment might change. So those molecules whose permanent dipole moment actually changes on vibration will show vibrational spectra. And other molecules whose permanent dipole moment do not change at all, they will not form vibrational spectra. So by these two rules, these are the two rules, okay, that we need to know. So by these two rules, homonuclear diatomic molecules like H2, Cl2, O2, and then N2, etc., do not form vibrational spectra as their dipole moment do not change, or simply you can say that they do not have dipole moment at all. So
it's they will definitely not change it, right? So homonuclear diatomic molecules such as H2, Cl2, O2, N2, etc. do not form vibrational spectra as their dipole moment do not change. So in examination, if it is asking do H2 or Cl2 form vibrational spectra, then you need to write no, because they will not interfere with the electromagnetic radiation at all, okay, because their dipole moment does not change. Now at the same time, let me erase this portion. At the same time, there are other molecules that form vibrational spectra. So to form vibrational spectra, their permanent dipole moment must change, right? So in this particular case, like NO, N2O, N2O, H2O, even carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide did not show rotational spectra, but it forms vibrational spectra, because to be rotationally active, it must have permanent dipole moment that carbon dioxide do not have. But with vibration, its dipole moment changes. So that is the criteria for vibrational spectra. So it forms vibrational spectra, okay? Similarly, ethene, etc. form vibrational spectra as they change their dipole moment with vibration. So this is the theoretical portion. As we see over here, homonuclear diatomic molecules do not form vibrational spectra. They do not form rotational spectra either, okay? Because they do not have permanent dipole moment, or simply their dipole moment do not change at all. Now, on the other hand, these type of molecules, NO, N2O, H2O, CO2, this CO2, carbon dioxide did not form rotational spectra, but it is forming vibrational spectra. I have already told the reason. For a molecule to be rotationally active, it must have permanent dipole moment that it does not have. It does not have permanent dipole moment, so it will not form rotational spectra or microwave spectra. But it forms vibrational spectra or infrared spectra. The reason for that is its dipole moment changes on vibration. So that is the criteria for vibrational spectra. So it forms vibrational spectra in this case. I hope you understood everything about selection rule for vibrational spectra. That's all in this video. If you like the video, please share this video as much as you can, and thank you for watching the video.